kilometers in busy streets. That one has 2-speed, that one is center opening. And that one I think is center opening. I don't know who made these. I believe these are older owners that got bought. These are the elevators at the Embassy Suites in South San Francisco, California. We're going up.
Oh, we're parking.
Do it now. Let's see if we can get the middle out of there. Your channel interlock. I'm gonna pause the video. We got this one. I think this is the service elevator. Thank you. be wrong, but I actually think these might be U.S. originally. There's a reason for that. Actually calls the middle elevator specifically.
We got this one. We haven't been on this one yet.
We're not going to take a round trip on this one, though. I've noticed on a lot of elevators. Either means they're being called. I pause the video because I usually don't like to film when other people are in elevators, but turns out it was, I'm not sure, the door opened and no one got in. I think someone called it but didn't get in. Is that a fire alarm horn in the elevator? Those of you who know fire alarms, I would like you to tell me what you think. That is the fan, I think. It's behaving differently now. Let's see what it does. We are parking, I believe. So from what I can tell, the controller in this elevator, if the arrow on the indicator lights up, it's been called. If not, it's parking. Just my observations. Looks like I was right. Indeed. The arrow on the indicator lights up when the elevator has a call. Hall or car. If not, then it's parking. This behavior may be observable on other elevators too, I don't know for sure. Observing these behaviors might actually be able to identify what controller an elevator has, but I would need more info to look into that. We'll get a fixture view. Don't mind, I didn't nudge mode. Let's see if we can show this.
Genfield, not anymore. I think that showed up pretty well. This is just a guess, but that size of the indicator makes me think US elevator. Digital 7-segment indicator.
Tell me if you agree. Also, the cabs kind of remind me of the US I once filmed in Salt Lake City. I don't know if I posted that video yet, though. Phoebe's actually like year-round access to the lobby.
Could be wrong, though.
Maybe on that one is a separate call button. Anyway, that's it. Let's watch these elevators move. I think we're getting this one. We'll send it down and call one up and watch them. These elevators have one-to-one cabling or roping. And of course the traction. See if you can see the counterweight, it might be on the other side. Oh. Don't know if you saw it go by, but there was the counterweight. I don't know if it's just from my perspective, but it looks like it only has four cables, not six. I think most modern elevators have six. Correct me if I'm wrong. That wasn't the best view. Oh, that would be a good view. Pretty sure that's only four cables, unless they're hiding behind the other cables. This is a lot brighter in person, by the way. You can see the car top station and the guide wheels. Oh, it's actually coming up here. I know it's going past. You can see under the car. I think those bolts might be the safety. Not sure. Full view. And let's see if I can show the door in the two-speed over there. You can see the door closers, or at least I can. Unfortunately, I don't think a lot of this is coming out great on camera. Anyway, that's it. These are lobby indicators. I don't know if I can show it. I don't think I can, but service car call. Fire service hall station. Over there, number four. Interesting. That's ERM access, I'm pretty sure. There's your arrow. I think that's Schindler. I could be wrong. Anyway, that's it.